Hey, today I'm gonna show you how to make your own fish salad. Like if you open a can of tuna and you make yourself tuna salad, you can make that with any kind of fish that you would normally take home and eat. And even bluefish, you have to like fish in order to eat bluefish. But if you pay the mate a couple extra bucks, and when he fillets the bluefish, you take all the dark meat out and you cook it the way I'm gonna show you how to cook this. In the boiling water to make salad, all the oils will foam up, you're gonna flush it out, and when you make the salad, it tastes pretty good. So I want you to try this. Today we happen to have some long fin tuna that we had frozen in the garage that I vacuum packed, and that's albacore. That's another name for albacore. So we got the water that's boiling now. It's just starting to boil pretty good, and all we do is we're gonna take this albacore, long fin tuna. We're going to dump it in. And when you dump in it was in a fridge. So when you dump it in at first, it cools the water and it stops boiling. And we're just going to watch to see if the couple bubbles start. It don't take long, just a couple of minutes. We're going to watch. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to put the timer on for 4 minutes. Okay, we're gonna just wait and see. We see a little bit boiling. A couple minutes more, and then once we do it, okay, it's starting to boil. We shut off the heat. We're gonna remove it from the heat, and we hit the timer. And in 4 minutes, when the timer goes off, what we're going to do is strain it. I'm going to have this bowl rinsed and we're going to make our salad, fish salad. So we'll continue in a minute. As soon as the alarm goes off, 4 minutes, I'll be back. Okay, so we brought it to a boil, took it off 4 minutes later, and look. Okay, this fish is an oil. This is a regular tuna fish, but you see there's some, you know, stuff floating up on the top, a little oil or whatever. And all we do next is now, so we're gonna go over to the sink. We're gonna go over to the sink and we're gonna put cold water on it and flush it. Like I said, if you like to try it with bluefish, a lot of people don't like bluefish, but all this oil, look at this, it'll all rise to the top and flush, okay, with the cold water. It really eliminates a lot of oil and fishy taste. Look, see the bubbles? See all the stuff coming out of it? And this is tuna. This is albacore tuna, long fin tuna. See, look. We're going to keep flushing it until it comes nice and clear and cools off. And then we're going to put it in a bowl and make the salad. Okay, I'm going to let this flush for a minute and then I'll put it back on again. Okay, we flushed out the tuna and look how nice it came. I drained it. Look how nice it came out, right? This is beautiful. Okay, we're gonna dump it in the bowl. Okay, we got two forks here. And just break it up like tuna, just like the tuna in a can, okay? This is incredible. See how it flakes? It flakes, it's cooked through, okay? You could actually leave it a little bit more than 4 minutes if you want, you know? It ain't gonna hurt it if you leave it a little more than 4 minutes. I had to answer the front door, so this stayed actually just a couple of minutes more than 4 minutes. See, we'll make this here like this. Look, beautiful. Okay. Like I said, you can make this with any kind of fish, okay? Okay, we're going to put this over here, turn the camera around. Okay, here we go. Okay, now you can put whatever kind of seasonings you want. Okay, when I normally make it, I just put, sometimes I cut up onions, little onion powder, celery salt, dill weed, generous helping of mayonnaise. But what I found out lately was I tried this, Mrs. Dash, or this, it's after this Dash, it's original, it's absolutely delicious. It's got a little spice, a little kick to it. So what we're going to do is just throw some spices in. Okay, we're going to put a little dash in here. Okay, this has got a little bit of a spicy to it. Put a little onion powder. Okay. I always put celery salt in. Look at celery salt. Okay. A little dill. Okay. And I'm telling you, any kind of fish you bring home that you would normally eat, you know, obviously nothing like a bait fish, but any kind of fish, you know, striped bass, blackfish, bluefish, any kind of fish you want to bring home, okay, let me just rinse off my hand quick. Okay. Let's give it a good mix. You know, you can smell the seasonings and they smell delicious, you know. A little onion, that Mrs. Dash, celery salt, a little dill. Look how nice this comes out, right? Look, this is absolutely beautiful. I'm gonna get a piece of bread and we'll try it. I'm just going to make a little half a sandwich just to taste it. And once again, you can make any fish you want. Once again, you cube it, you cube your fish, you boil the water, you pour the cubed fish in, and then it'll cool it off, it'll stop boiling. You watch, once you see a few bubbles coming up, like it starts to reboil, you take it off. You set the timer for 4 minutes, okay? And then you'll see oils from the fish, whatever kind of fish it is, come up, be bubbly on the top, and you flush it with cold water until it's nice and clean, and put it in the colander and drain it. And you see how nice it comes out in flakes, all right? So let's see here. Okay, so now we got a little tuna fish sandwich there, long fin tuna, which is albacore, like you're buying a can. This is delicious. I think it's better than canned tuna, you know, because it's fresh. Awesome. Okay, I hope you enjoy it. Try making it with any kind of fish you want that you would normally take home and eat, and you're gonna love it. Simple. Give it a try.